Yo, what up, it's Don.
Sammy Lee here.
Reyna is on one today.
Oh my god. Oh my
What's up, Soul Squad?
Dude. Alright, so we did a video on this already, but it wasn't as bad. Alright, so this is an issue already on the 0.2, as you guys already know. Right? And the 0.2 had this defect. I don't know if it's a defect, but I mean, a whole bunch of you guys sent these over. And so shout out to the Soul Squad for actually testing these shoes and stuff. And because I don't really play in the 0.2s as much. I like haven't played in it for like a good couple weeks because I want to play my, you know, PG3s, my KT4s, and my KT12s, you know. Even though the 0.2 is super nice, I just want to play in those shoes more, you know what I'm saying? So when they first came out, like the PG3s and stuff, it wasn't out yet, so I was playing in those a little bit more, but right now I'm not. So so shout out to you guys for sending these out. But yeah, so I think, you know, like the Curry 6 defect, that happened like right away. Like first day or after a couple days, maybe even like a week, then, you know, if it was gonna happen, the rubber does, you know, peel off, right? The 0.2, I think this happens maybe after like a month or two, because this really takes like, you know, like stretching of the outsole and stuff, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that's why we're seeing it like a little bit later after the release of the shoe. And it happened a lot also in like this I don't want to call it ugly because you guys have this shoe, but you know the All-Star colorway with the, you know, pink outsole, yeah. Whatever. And it's been happening to some of those as well. So
that's a weird looking defect. You know,
it's happening in the same exact. You see all these pictures. Yeah, same exact spot. Dude.
Is there a zoom unit in the forefoot?
Yeah, there is.
So it's on the edge of the zoom unit.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah,
exactly. So they the zoom unit, right? It's outlined. So they cut a you know, place inside the midsole so they can place the zoom unit, you know, inside the shoe, obviously, right? And then they didn't fill in the midsole, you know, the perimeter of the zoom unit properly or something. Cause maybe I'm thinking there is a little bit of a space or air pocket there, and then there's the outsole. So when you stretch it and when you're playing, you know, it stretches the outsole a little bit. And once you keep doing that a little too much, the rubber gets weak and it rips.
Yeah.
You know, so I don't know if it like actually like. Dude, look at this. You see all the nubs also?
Yeah.
See that ripping? Yeah, that's the durability is not very good on that shoe. But I don't know if that'll affect the shoe though. You think so? Like playing in it? I don't think so, right? Because like when you're doing movements, lateral
just having a little cut in it, you mean?
Yeah, exactly, right?
Yeah, maybe not.
I don't think so.
Definitely, like, I don't know. It's definitely, I wouldn't keep hooping in them.
Yeah, that's true. Like, I'd be mad too. I'd be mad, yeah.
I mean, Nike will probably take them back. I don't know how long their return policy is as far as defects go.
I think the return policy for defects is like 6 months or maybe even a year.
Oh, wow.
But just to return it, because you didn't like the shoe or whatever, the return policy is really great, is a month. So if you got it within a month, then you can definitely return it, no questions asked. But if you are looking to return it, you know, just go ahead and call Nike customer service and just ask them. You know, they're very nice. Adidas sucks. Their customer service sucks. But Nike is great. So yeah, I mean, shout out to you guys. I'm gonna try to shout out each and every one of you. But there are a whole bunch of pictures and stuff like that.
Yeah, let us know in the comments if any of you guys have experienced this too, the 0.2s.
Yeah.
Sammy hasn't, but. Then again,
I haven't been playing it, you know what I'm saying? So, also, if you guys can see from some of these pictures, like I said, the nubs do rip off. So, you know, durability already is not very good on the outsole. But yeah, that's crazy. That's a huge ass.
That's gnarly.
That looks like the Joker smiley face, dude.
Yeah.
That's how big that is. Yeah. Oh my god. So, that's right where the outline of the shoe is, man.
Yeah.
It just boggles my mind to see, like, did they like not test this? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, how does this even happen?
Yeah,
like,
how does it happen?
What is the test process of the shoes when you're making it? Like, from each of these companies, you know what I'm saying? The Curry 6, how does that happen? You know, like, everyone, like, all the reviewers, when we first got it happened like the first few days. You know, so like, if you know, even tested it for a little bit, that would have happened. The companies would have known.
And that's like Under Armour's number one shoe.
Yes.
that should be their only concern as far as their footwear division goes, is that shoe.
Yeah.
The Nike and Jordan, I can kind of see, like got so many SIGs and so many shoes. You know, this the fact that this happens every now and then, I'm not really too surprised.
Yeah.
But for it to happen to the Curry 6 is pretty crazy.
I understand this not happening to Russell Westbrook because he probably gets like a new shoe every single practice. You know what I'm saying? So 100%. It's not going to happen to him. But like, don't you have other people testing these shoes and shit? You know what I'm saying? Like, this should have happened and you guys should have seen that this was happening. So, I don't know, man. Like, also, like, how do you think they would fix this?
They wouldn't.
Right?
No. They would just, you know, slowly just start, you know, accepting a loss on the shoe, I think. If anyone returning the shoe, let him
return it. Not like right now, but like...
Oh, in what the
do
future?
You think, or like, what do you think they could have fixed or done better to prevent this problem?
It obviously has something to do with the Zoom unit.
Yeah.
So there must have been some design flaw in the way that they implemented that there. Or just maybe not a design flaw, but a mistake in the manufacturing.
Yeah.
Which happens, you know?
Oh, no, I think it is a design because it's happening to all the colorways, dude.
Yeah, but maybe... whoever in the production didn't execute their design properly, you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And there was some type of default in the way the Zoom unit was placed, or who knows, you know? Or maybe just the actual outsole was too thin.
I think so. I think that's what it is.
You know?
It looks super thin. Like, it's happening to the All-Star colorway right here. You guys can see that. It's happening to the BHM. It's happening to the Family or whatever. And then it's happening to the original colorway as well.
They might have done that. They might have done that to try to keep the weight down because it's already, you know, not the lightest shoe.
Yeah.
And that's a good way to cut weight is the rubber outsole is pretty heavy.
Looking at it, it does look really thin. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, like the nubs, like the actual half circles are really thick. So maybe because of that, they tried making the base layer rubber really thin or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm not 100% sure what it is. But
thinking it doesn't need to be too thick because it's never going to be in contact with
the ground.
But right. I don't know.
Yeah, that is true. So anyway, just wanted to warn you guys. So if you guys, I mean, the 0.2 is a dope performer. I really like playing in those shoes. Like I said, I'm playing in my go-to shoes, like the Hardens, KT4s, and PG3s, because I like to play in those more. But the 0.2, nonetheless, is a really nice performer. Nice shoe to play. Just be wary of this. Just be careful. If you tried returning it, if this is one of you guys and you guys tried returning it and stuff, even if it's after a month, tell us what happened down in the comment section below. Like, did they let you return it or anything? You know what I'm saying? But yeah, so I mean, I'm not saying not to get the 0.2, but this is happening to a lot of people, and a lot of you guys have sent this over now that you guys have, you know, played in the shoe for a while. So,
but Nike's super legit. If you have any type of problem like that, they'll take the shoe back.
Exactly. So, not too worried on that, but it does suck. I hate the return process. You know, you have to send it back, you have to go to the store, waste gas, waste time and shit.
Yeah, for us, we live close to Nike stores, but maybe you don't.
Exactly.
And then, you gotta mail it back or something.
Yeah, so, anyways, that's a 0.2 defect, right? We're calling it a defect. I think enough of you guys have sent us pictures of the exact same, you know, spot as well, ripping. So I guess we'll call it a defect, but just be careful. But just want to help you guys out. Hope we did help you guys out. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you guys next one.
Later. Peace.